Welcome back to Proactive. Well, Southern Gold is getting ready to kick off drill testing at its Goseong project in South Korea, and it's also looking to expand its exploration strategy in the region. Here to discuss all of that and more is the Southern Gold CEO and Managing Director, Robert Smillie. Robert, welcome to the program. It's good to have you on.
Hi, Elisha. Great to be here.
So, Rob, as I mentioned at the top there, you're getting ready for this drill testing program. It's going to kick off at Goseong around February 2023. Can you tell us a little bit about the project and why you've sort of chosen to move in this direction?
Sure. Yeah. Thanks, Alicia. Look, it's a really exciting project. The team have done a lot of great work this year in the project generation space. And this is a project that the team brought in around about back in July. It's a fascinating project. It's over an historic copper producing area, but really little work done in terms of gold. And some of the sampling work that we've done has returned some really good gold assays. So it's over an historic mining area, several historic producing mines, some very large mineralized structures, and just really a large mineralized system. So the team and I, we really like it because it has this potential, not just for the vein-hosted material as well, but also potential for intrusive-hosted mineralization, because we believe we're a bit deeper than some of the epithermal systems that we've been looking at. So it really is a very exciting project that we're very, very keen to work up.
Now, Robert, what needs to happen between now and February in order to get this drill testing underway?
That's a great question. So we're going to be very busy. I've got a program of work lined up with the team. We're going to kick off with a drone aerial magnetic survey that's going to be conducted for us by KIGM, which is the South Korean Geological Survey. We're really lucky to be able to partner with them for them to do this work for us. That's going to be really valuable for helping us firm up these areas, also to identify some of the structural trends as well. And hopefully also maybe to see some intrusive kind of targets in there that we might be able to drill test. So there's the geophysics, also a program of soil sampling over some of these areas, plus combined with some detailed structural mapping. So quite a lot of work coming up over the next few months. And luckily, because it's in the southern part of the country, the team will be able to work over there through the November, December, January, winter months, which will be just really fantastic.
Sounds like you remain busy over the Christmas season. Now, Rob, the interesting thing about this announcement is it came off quite a busy week for you guys. Indeed, a couple of days later, Southern Gold announced that it was broadening its exploration strategy. You've recently focused more so on those precious metals in South Korea, but now you'd also look to find items like copper, lithium, and rare earth elements as well. What's led to this expansion of your strategy?
Yeah, well, I've been living in Korea for the last year now and been traveling around the country quite a fair bit and just seeing the other opportunities that are here. And we do know that there has been historical mining of lithium and not so much of the rare earths and a little bit of exploration in that space. So we thought, look, this is something that we really should be investigating because there's no one else here in the whole country basically doing it. And so we commissioned a study by Geological Consulting Group, RSC, back in New Zealand to do a desktop, I guess, prospectivity analysis of the country to come up and see, are there any regions that really would be worth following up on the ground using a mineral systems approach? And that was a great study. It came up some really, really interesting areas that are definitely worth following up, definitely permissive geology, definitely seeing some great things in the regional data sets that KIGM had in terms of the geophysics and the geochemistry. So this is something that we really think is a good complementary program to our precious metal program. Let's get out there. Let's look for some of these other elements as well, because we're out there. We've got the capability. Let's just get out there and chase these things up as well.
All right. Wrapping up for today, Rob, can you give us a little bit of a taste of what's to come? What's Southern Gold got lined up in terms of the next couple of milestones or activities that you'd like to report on?
Sure. Well, obviously, the main one is kicking off with the drilling planned in February at Goseong. We're keen to move on after that to a couple of our other projects that we want to work up as well. At Dokon, one of our main projects, we're going to be conducting a gravity survey in that area to try and find and identify a large mineralized structure that we want to drill test, as well as other work. So, and then moving on to Dokcheong to do some drilling there as well. So basically going to be very busy hitting the drill targets the first quarter of next year. It's going to be a lot going on in that space. And then obviously after the winter months, kicking off with the critical minerals, lithium and rare earth program, getting out in the field and testing these anomalies and seeing what the team can find. So an extremely busy and really exciting time for the company. We're absolutely stoked.
Sounds like there's a lot more news to come from these camps, and we'll continue to follow the Southern Gold story. Thank you so much for your time today. Really appreciate it.
Thanks very much, Alicia.